this is how we're going to start this one off. So now it's boom, it's a perfect loop. And I guess you guys probably didn't hear it before because the stream ended. I'm not sure where it ended. But yeah, picking right back up where we left off. Here we go. So we got spaced. So that's exactly what I'm trying to do right there, is just have those little spaces so we can get like a really big like kick drum in there, and so it kind of like ebbs and flows. And that's kind of what I'm going to do with the melody too. So this is going to kind of be like my chord progression, and then I'm going to try to find, actually, you know what, we've got that little guitar, so we might as well use this little dual guitar melody. Is that the one that I wanted? Maybe it was nylon guitar. Let me listen to this. Which one? It was something. No, I think it was a dual guitar melody. All right, we're going to drag this in here and see if we can cut up a little bit from this. This is super quiet. This is at 110, so let's go ahead and just speed it up a little bit. Speed it up by 1.15, and then it's in C minor, and we're in D major, so D major is G minor, C, D, E, F, G, so I need to go up. Oh, wait, no, C sharp. D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G. So seven, maybe, if I can do math, or if I can count. There's no math involved in counting, but. That is not even close. Let's try again. Maybe it's eight. Maybe it's supposed to be A. Wait, no. It should be 6 because it's C sharp minor. Maybe 4. Maybe it is A. Alright, and I want this to come in on the second beat, and then now I'm just going to try to line this up with the grid. I'm just going to take the one run of each of these. The ding, 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 ding. And then I'm going to try to make sure everything is kind of lined up. We're going to do the same thing. I'm not going to do the math on this because I don't want to. So I'm just going to stretch it out how I normally stretch things out with the bend marker. And we're going to put these notes on where I want them to be. So this is what we're going to do. Boom. And then, so I usually grab the peak of each note and just drag it onto the last bar. And we're just going to do every other one here. We'll give it a little bit of swag here and there. Ba-dum-bum-bum. But mainly, I'm just going to do every bar. Or every half bar. And my light just went out. We're full of technical malfunctions tonight. Lots of technical difficulties in the stew. I just got new monitors today, so maybe it has something to do with it. Maybe I'm just cursed for buying new monitors. I don't know. Boom, boom, boom. Let's see. Boom, boom. And then I'm going to bring this. this out here, and then we're going to pull this one. Oh, we'll just leave that. All right, let's see what that sounds like. Okay, so that's really not great. It's kind of stagnant, so I'm going to swag these out a little bit. Ding, ding, ding. Give them a little bit more rhythm. So I put them on just like straight eighth notes, but now I kind of want to give them a little melody and give them a little swing so I can just kind of do whatever I want. I've already got the markers set right at the peak of each one of these notes, so I can pretty much do whatever I want to it. Like if I want to keep going and change it up, I can do that. But let's see what we got. See what happens when we duplicate this. Whoops. Let me get out of here. Take this whole thing, duplicate it. Alright, let's see what this sounds like. And then on the first one, I think I'm gonna cut off that last note. So we're just gonna do this. Cut it off. And we'll give it a little fade out. Fade this one in, and then boom. And I think that's pretty cool, little dual melody we got going on here. Duplicate it and see what happens. Then we're going to do, so I'm going to give it a little,